we are here at Carmax, and we're gonna see what they tell us, right? Yo, what is up, guys? This is your boy Lopes. I don't have my little selfie stick or whatever, so you are a little closer to me because I'm holding you in my hand. But so we're driving the Scat. Look at that little bee. You know, I always gotta, show the little bee. But I'm here, guys. I'm loving driving this Scat, and we're on our way. But where? To where? Where are we actually going? After me having this car for a month, what the hell is CarMax going to give me? Wow. Look at this thing. Wow. I don't know, man. My man. I think that spoiler is a little too small for you. For your car. Your bumper. I don't know. It's like a miniature spoiler on this car. Anyways, so here's the premise, right? We are going to CarMax. Why? Well, because I'm never satisfied, guys. I definitely never am. So the Scatpack is cool. I love it. I don't love it. I really like it. Really, really like it. It's a good daily driver. It's a good commuter. It's comfortable as hell. And it's fast, right? It is a little bit sluggish, and it's heavy as hell. And most importantly, it's not as exclusive or as, it doesn't have that wow factor, right? Maybe, if I had a Scat Pack wide body, maybe it would have that wide factor, but probably not. So I stop all my searches on the Scat Pack wide body. And now, quite honestly, I am talking to dealers, setting stuff up so we can get another GT350 on this channel. I don't know. I'm in the talks. Maybe a ZL1. I'll put it out in another video, or I already did, where stuff that I thought was going to happen with family, with my wife's job, and stuff like that didn't really pan out. To tell you the truth, didn't really pan out. So come to find out, it's not like I really, really need this commuter right now. And I just gotta put my big boy pants on and freaking deal with any car that I'm gonna get right now is going to be a commuter. But let's look at this guy again. Hold on. So to his defense, he is like an older gentleman. Let's just say, but look at this wing, guys. Look at this thing. Come on, man. I mean, you have to know that that doesn't look good. You just have to. I don't know, but my man, you really need to take that off. Oh man. Anyways, so I don't know. But in preparation, I told you guys that when I first bought this car, the very next day, I took it to a dealership and had them do me a trade-in appraisal. And right off the bat, they were offering me $2,000 more than what I already paid for. Now, I did Vroom, I did Carvana, I did all that good stuff. I didn't do CarMax. So I tried to do CarMax yesterday, and it told me that I have to actually go in so that they can give me a fair price. So that's where we're going right now. Now, a little premise on that beforehand is that Carvana offered me still $2,000 over what I owe on the car, so they match whatever that dealership did. And Vroom's been sketchy. Right, Vroom at first offered me $5,000. Right, want to say like 2 weeks ago. Then they offered me $4,000. Now they're offering me what I owe on it. So it's like, what the hell? Is it because I did it too many times? I don't know. But either way, we are here at CarMax and we're gonna see what they tell us, right? What are they gonna tell us? What are they going to offer us for the car? Because I will say, I did see some GT350s and Z01s that I do like at CarMax, right? So let's see. I don't know. I don't want to really talk to the salesman that I almost bought a car from here. So hopefully I can sneak in before he actually sees me. But yeah, we'll know and we'll see. We'll see what they offered me.
That's one eternity later.
We just left CarMax and, you know, I'm not mad about their offer, quite honestly. It wasn't bad. It wasn't great, but it wasn't bad. At least I know I'm not losing money, right? So that's the good thing. I'm still making a little bit of money from what I currently owe on the car. I'm not getting all my money back, right? From what I, from the positive equity of the GT350 towards this car, but definitely still owe a lot less than what they offered me. So let me show you guys. So there we go, if you guys can see there, right? So I mean, they were cool about it. They definitely wanted the car because the guy was trying to sell me on actually bringing it in and selling it. It wasn't a bad price, but it wasn't the best price, right? Now, I know this has been done to death. I'm gonna take my car to CarMax and this and this and that. I'm actually trying to find out what the car is worth, right? And I'll tell you why in a second. But before I tell you why, let's just say that CarMax came in at an okay price, you know? It wasn't the worst, it wasn't the best. It felt kind of in the middle, right? And that's fine, you know, because even with their offer, I'm not losing money. And that's the good thing. I still have positive equity that I can move over to another car if I choose to, right? Or I just sell them the car and then, you know, is what it is. So it definitely gave me something to think about. I said before, Vroom offered me the most for this car. They offered me 47 and some change. I don't remember. Guys, that's like $6,000 over what I owe right now, right? On this car. And that's an amazing price. Unfortunately, I didn't take it. And that was 2 weeks ago. So when I went back to Vroom about a week ago, because their things are only a week, just like CarMax, they lowered it down to 46. And I was like, what's going on here? But still, 46 is, you know, it's all right. 46 and some change. Now, I checked Vroom, and it's at 42. 42,000, so even less than CarMax. Now, obviously, they're fluctuating, and maybe I'm tainting it a little bit because I keep checking the price every week. So they're like, you know what? This guy's never gonna sell us this car. Let's just give him a crappy offer, you know? So maybe I should chill about a week or two before, you know, giving them another try. Carvana was actually really good. They were like 44 and some change. And their offer is actually good until the 24th of December. Wow. So for 30 days, that offer is pretty good. So gives me something to think about. And then these people are at 43. I had two Ford dealerships. Actually, two Ford dealerships and one Dodge dealership. Give me some crappy ass offers, guys. The Dodge dealership was the worst. And you would think that they would give you the most, but they didn't. They offered me 39. I was like, what? Oh, that's KBB Valley. I'm like, I'm looking at the KBB right now. KBB says 45. What are you talking about? No. they couldn't really explain it. They just wanted to give me 39. I was like, all right, forget you. They had a GT350 there. That's why I was actually inquiring. Then, two Ford dealerships. One with a GT350. The other one with a Mach 1. Brand new Mach 1, right? It wasn't a premium, so that's where I was kind of like, eh. Both of those offered me 41K, you know? Which is just a little over what I owe, right? So still a little bit of positive equity coming over, but not much, right? And then obviously I got these other offers from other dealerships. So what I'm saying with that is that check your different dealerships, check all your resources. AutoNation was giving me a great price for the GT350, but they're giving me crap for this one. Well, not crap, but not good. They're giving me like 42.5, right? CarMax gave me an okay price for this one, but then for the GT350, they were giving me crap. They were giving me 48. Guys, I ended up trading in the GT350 for 55, basically what I paid for it. It's crazy. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. You gotta check around, go to your different resources, and then have them play against each other, guys, because that's the only way that you're gonna get a good deal nowadays. You're gonna find that one car, that one dealership that just wants to move that car, and they're willing to do anything to move it. Whether it's taking your car in for a trade and basically giving you more money, lowering the price on their car, but whatever, they just want to move that car, right? So that's where we're at, right? Now, I told you, why am I looking at other cars? Well, some things that I thought were going to happen did not pan out, right? Family, my wife and job, she's remote. She's always been remote even before COVID, but it looked like she was having to start to, she just got a group under her. She is a manager and she was going to have to start, you know, traveling a little bit more in her car, which leaves me without her car to use. Plus some family was going to stay with us for an indefinite time. Well, none of that panned out, right? So now I'm using this car, right, for a daily driver, but I don't drive that much. You know, I go and I pick up the kids sometimes. I take the kids with me sometimes, but that's really it, right? I mean, I think the most hassle of having the GT350 was taking it out of the cover. That's it. Because my kids weren't even in it that much, unless we were going to a car show or for some reason my wife was using her car, which she doesn't go out that much. Going to like get her hair done, doing her nails, meeting up with her family or friends or something like that. But it's not even that much, right? So this car is an amazing car. But I do miss the GT350. I'm not gonna front. I miss the exclusivity of it. I do. And while this car is great, I kind of want that GT350 back.